letting you know that your job is difficult when you're on the truck. As far as organizational stuff, okay, just be ready to go this line in jokes. Okay, that's all you gotta do. If you finish the course, you're done. Okay, blockers, you're probably confused out there. That's fine, that's what I was looking for, okay? What I just wanna see everybody doing is, once you finish an engagement zone, I want you turning back around and going to the next empty space to potentially catch the jammer coming from the pair that's there. Okay? So, right. What this is mimicking, it's mimicking almost like red light. I know it's the first rep is a little weird because it goes so far around. Okay? I just want us to get into the habit of being as close to our friends to catch as possible so we understand where to go to. Okay? Does that work? Can we do that? Yeah? Okay. If it's too confusing, then we'll just do one engagement zone. Okay?
Yeah,
you're giving them just a little bit of buffer space there. Yeah. So you guys don't run into each other.
And if they lose a jammer, like this, they always over here and then cycle back over here.
If they lose a jammer where?
So like they were going from here and then going around to the next part of here. Okay, they start losing here and they start going back.
No, they're always just trying to go backwards. Go backwards to an empty section that's closest to the next one.
Oh, then backwards.
Yeah. Okay.
If we can buy one set of blockers in Canada, are we allowed to hit the next set of blockers with speed, or do you want us to slow down?
No, I want, if you earn that speed, you get to keep that speed. Okay? Right. No, you have to go right by them. Okay? Yeah, you earn that speed. Use it. If the blockers are busy with somebody, just go by and you'll meet a pair eventually, okay? Unless you're at the end.
Yeah.
required. They just went to the next section and got them ready to catch an incoming kick. So sometimes they went two, sometimes they went one, whatever happened, it happened. But it looked much more organized, and all of you were recycling. That's what I care about, that you're going to one spot and you're hustling back, get ready to catch another jam. Okay? A couple things that we can talk about. Jesse mentioned one was, you don't mind? Fury, you're very good with speed, so come on in for a second. So if Fury earned her speed and she's coming in with speed, a lot of you right now are in the middle of the track and giving them two sides to work with. Okay? That is theirs. So let's try and funnel them to a side. So if Jesse and I see Fury coming with speed, we're like, this lane is ours, we know that we committed her to that side, and now we go that side. Okay? So we're taking that option away. The tricky part with this is the timing. If you go too early, if Fury throws one of her patented shoulder jukes a little, okay, you're going to leave too early and you're going to give up that side. So you got to wait to see them commit. Most of the time they'll commit with their eyes, but jammers are getting smart, looking in other directions that they're not going to go, okay? So I usually watch their chest and I wait until they go. Some people watch hips, some people watch feet. Find out what their tell is so that you know when they're going to go. Okay, the other thing is absorbing impact from a jammer who's coming pretty much dead right at you. If you don't mind, just come to this spot. Some jammers just want to come in, hit, and make a move. And some of you right now are just taking the contact and being pushed forward. Okay? That's okay.
Okay?
So if you see a jammer coming in, you want to take their speedway by actually kind of backing into them, but not trying to knock them backwards. You want to kind of meet their impact so they knock you forward a touch. Okay? So come in. Okay. Right? So what I did was I kind of stopped her in her spot without sending her in the wrong direction, okay, and I absorbed some of the impact out of her body to take her speed away. But I still absorbed it enough so that my, I absorbed the contact, but I still maintained proper direction by letting my feet go forward. So if you see a jammer that's coming in and you know that they're just gonna make contact first, they have like a habit of doing that, that we play a lot of jammers that always hit first and make their second, their next after that, take some of that impact, okay? Cool, let's try this some more. This is fun. Oh, was there a question? Killa, do you have a question?
No.
Okay.